뉴스의 중심 워싱턴 나우. 안녕하세요. 정인설의 워싱턴 나우입니다. 오늘은 모더나의 공동 창업자인 로버트 랭과 MIT 교수 인터뷰로 꾸몄습니다. 이분은 40년간 생화학 한 우물을 봤고요. 특허를 1,400개 보유하고 있습니다. 창업도 40회나 했고 명예박사학위까지 포함해서 35개 학위가 있습니다. 이분과 함께 머스크가 최근에 개발한 먹는 코로나19 치료제, 그리고 백신의 부작용, 부스터샷, 그리고 백신 특허 문제까지 한번 얘기를 들어봤습니다.
both important. My feeling is, I mean, the first line of defense is certainly vaccines. I mean, you want to make sure people don't get COVID in the first place. So I think the vaccines are clearly the most important thing. But if somebody does not take the vaccine, which I think is a huge mistake, I mean, because certainly these pills are only 50% effective, you know, but if somebody doesn't take the vaccine or there's a breakthrough case, you know, it's, you want to have other lines of defense too. I think you want as many lines of defense as possible. You know, masks I think are important. I think vaccines are extremely important, but I think it's great that there's this pill. I think it can only help. But so I think that would be a second or third line of defense after vaccines. 이 think there's two separate issues. First, there's the issue of having enough doses to send to countries that don't have any. That's one issue is supply. I think, though, the issue that you generally hear about, at least in the United States, is should you get it or not? I think there's no question that you should get it. What happens is there is some waning of the antibody titers and immune cells over time. So the way I look at it is the amounts of side effects to the patient are essentially minimal. The benefit, you know, if you to the patient in terms of not getting COVID are enormous. The risk is very low and the reward is very high. So I think that there's no question in my mind that if you just deal with what's best for any individual patient, I think it's a good idea to get it. I certainly got it. And I think most everybody I know gets it or wants to get it. 이 my guess is that you probably would. I mean, that certainly when you get a vaccine, the antibodies and the immune cells, they wane, they lower over time. It's also possible that there'll be other variants as well. I think my expectation is that you will. I'm not a medical doctor, you know, or even a vaccine expert, but my expectation is from what I've seen so far is I expect people would. I'd rather see people be safe than sorry. You know, it's like, again, I think the benefit is high and the risk is low. 're actually very, very few. Certainly on the RNA vaccines, I mean, when you look at it and even compared to flu vaccines or anything, I mean, they're really minimal side effects. That doesn't mean there's none, but I mean, people can get side effects from almost anything. So to me, from everything I've watched and everything that's been published in the medical literature, the benefit of getting the vaccine is very, very high.
95%
You'll still get millions of people dying if you don't take the vaccine. I think you certainly want to take the vaccine, I mean, regardless. But I think it's good that there are other things that if people do get COVID, that you have ways that at least have some potential to treat it. But the pill is not nearly as effective as the vaccine. I think the data certainly show that. 백신s are doing a great job against COVID-19, but we're not done yet. And I think it would be a mistake to think that we're done yet. You know, I think we still have to, we haven't beat it. I think we're fighting it. And I think the vaccines have, you know, changed the world. But that being said, I think there's what's really happened in the past year and a half is I think this is a great victory for science. I think you'll see, and particular for biotechnology science. So I think what you'll see is more and more vaccines, more genetic therapeutics like messenger RNA and things like that. I'll follow the data. I'll follow recommendations from clinicians, the Center for Disease Control, and places like that, and the FDA. From the data that I've seen so far, it seems to me likely that you'll get a waning of antibody titers, but we'll just have to see what the data looks like. You know, there have been a lot of publications in medical journals, very good medical journals, in the past few months, and they've certainly shown that the vaccines work extremely well. There is a waning over time. And I think that provides high motivation for people to get the booster. I think we'll have to see again what the data looks like 6 months, a year from now. And I think that will also help inform, places like the Center for Disease Control and the FDA and various other Asian and European authorities about, what recommendations they would make. Well, again, I'd follow whatever the authorities tell you, and I think they may tell you different things with different vaccines. It seems to me like the messenger RNA vaccines are very, very safe. I expect the Pfizer and Moderna ones will be approved for different things. Pfizer's already been approved in a number, Moderna as well. But I think you'll see more and more of that over the next month. But I would, again, follow what the regulatory authorities, and at least in the U.S. Center for Disease Control, suggest. I think it would be good to have studies. And, again, I'm not an expert on that. My expectation, just at a purely theoretical basis, is it's probably okay. Again, I think you'd want to see more and more data. A lot of this is just listed on the Moderna website. I mean, Moderna is working on many different vaccines, for flu, for respiratory diseases, for CMV. I mean, there's a lot of different ones that Moderna is working on, and they may do combination vaccines. I think there'll be more COVID vaccines as well. So I think there's a whole arsenal of vaccines that Moderna has worked on. That's all, like I say, on their website, and it's public information. Well, I'm probably not the best judge of that. Juan Andres, who's outstanding, who leads our manufacturing program at Moderna, would probably be the best judge. Certainly Samsung's a great company, but manufacturing messenger RNA vaccines are non-trivial. And, so it requires not only the messenger RNA, but creating the lipid nanoparticles and incorporating them and doing a lot of quality control. So, I mean, Moderna itself has built a huge facility in Norwood, Massachusetts, and, is expanding that facility. I think certainly it would take any company, no matter how good that company is, time to go up the learning curve. We've seen problems, actually, with companies even good companies trying to manufacturing of different vaccines. It would certainly take time for them to get up the learning curve. Yeah, I'm not sure I'm an expert on that. I mean, I have a number of Korean companies. I've had a lot of Korean scientists train in my laboratory, and they've been excellent. Well, I've had a lot of my students who train and go back to be professors or work in Korean companies. True. I'm actually an advisor to 4 Korean companies, MepsGen, Genove, Gene Medicine, and AproBio. And they're all great companies, and the scientists there are really, really smart. They're developing new ways to treat cancer and ALS and Alzheimer's and developing organs on a chip. They're really doing a lot of really innovative work. I think it is because the scientists are extremely good. Let me just say, Moderna's policy, which has been publicly announced, is during the pandemic, Moderna's not going to force any of the patents, during the pandemic. I mean, that's been announced for a year now. So I guess the question is, should that happen forever? The way I look at it is a couple of things. One, I think the patents are only one issue. I mean, the biggest issue, really, if the goal is to get vaccines to many countries around the world, is manufacturing. I mean, and I don't think that just giving the patents away will change manufacturing. Manufacturing, you're going to need experienced people who can do manufacturing, and you're going to need facilities that can do that. In fact, Moderna just announced, I think earlier today, about building a up to $500 million plant in Africa to help on these things. But also, I think there's a big downside of just giving the patents and assuming that anybody can make these. One issue, again, goes back to manufacturing. It's not simple. I mean, lots of companies have run into problems on manufacturing. Johnson & Johnson, for example, worked with an experienced company, Emergent BioSolutions. They unfortunately got a lot of contamination. Good thing, at least, is that the United States Food and Drug Administration was there. They're very experienced, and they told them they had to shut it down. But if you didn't have an experienced organization like the FDA, those vaccines would have gone out and killed people. I think the second problem that I worry about is more in the long run. You know, if I look at the United States, the only real company that's been doing the COVID vaccine is Moderna. So to me, what happens is, just going back in time, investors have a choice, right? Investors, especially in a capitalist society, they're supposed to make money. So they have a choice. They could invest in a Moderna or they could invest in a Facebook. And if you start giving patents away, nobody will invest in the Modernas of the future because it costs billions of dollars to create a new drug or a vaccine. And if anybody could do it, well, then the investors will feel they're going to lose money. So they'll keep investing in the Facebooks of the world and not the Modernas. And I think we don't want that. I think it would be great that there'd be more companies that are trying to save human life rather than do things like Facebook. And we certainly saw, like, Angela Merkel, you know, in charge of Germany, has certainly felt the same way. And by the way, Germany has two companies, CureVac and BioNTech, creating messenger RNA drugs and vaccines.